Hi guys, so today we are going to build this cool animation using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Okay, let's get started. So this is my index.html file and index.html here, my style.css and my custom script file. So I have included the font of some file library here using CDN, and this is my style.css file. So my CSS gets converted to CSS. So I have downloaded the jQuery and included it offline. This is my custom script file. So first I am going to write a div with a class of container, and inside this container I am going to have a UL with a class of loveLoader. Okay, and I am going to have a single li here. Inside this li I'm going to have font awesome class fa-heart. Okay, so when I click on save, you can see the icon is available here. Okay, next let's quickly jump to CSS. I'm making use of some colors. So color hash FFF5154. Okay, FF. So this is a red color, and I'm going to use a function called rem, and it takes a value and it returns unquote dollar value divided by 1 pixel divided by 1 pixel whole divided by 16 plus rem. So basically what it is doing is converting my pixel values to rems. Okay, so if I write something like this, say if I'm having a h1 here, and if I write font size to be rem of 20 pixel, so the 20 pixel gets converted to rem values here using this function. Okay, fine. Now let's target the container first. So I'm copying it here and setting the position to fixed top to 0, bottom to 0, left to 0, right to 0, and set the margin to auto, display element as flex, justify content as center, and align items to center again. Okay, click on save. So as you can see, our font awesome icon is centered on the page. Now let's target the loveLoader UL. I'm copying the loveLoader and pasting it here. Border 1 pixel solid. Okay, let's remove the padding on this element. So removing the padding. And setting the margin to 0. Fine. Next, let's position this element as absolute. Clicking on save. Now, let's get rid of this bullet here. So, I'm setting the list item, list style type to none. And we'll display the element as inline flex. Next, let's justify the content to center and align items to center. Okay. because the element is positioned absolute, I am setting the top to 0, bottom to 0, left to 0, right to 0, and margin auto. So simple technique to center the element on the page when it is positioned absolute. Okay, I am setting some height 40 pixel and also width 40 pixel. So I'm using a rem function which converts the pixel values to rems here. Okay, so this is the UL and this is the LI item, and we'll target the LI inside the UL. We'll display it as inline flex again. We'll justify the content to center. And we'll align items to center. We are going to position this element as absolute again. So when I click on save, this is the effect there. Okay. So right now nothing affected. So our LS, our icon will be a big value. So we will be setting the font size to be a higher value. So to make the element centered there, what we can do is we can set the left to -100% and right to -100%. Top to -100% and bottom to -100% and set the margin to auto. Okay. Next, what I'm going to do is I'll be adding two classes for this LI item using JavaScript. So one item is even and one list item would be odd. So I'll be adding even and odd classes to this LI item using JavaScript. So I'm making use of these classes. Just to differentiate the color, I'm using this. Okay. So darken dollar color 20% and color lighten 20%. Okay, so we are done with this. Let's quickly jump to JavaScript. So since we have included the jQuery, I'm directly writing document.ready and function inside this, and let's create a variable interval. So what I want is we are continuously adding LI items to this DOM. So to remove the overhead, what I'm going to do is when the window is focused, then only we'll be adding the LI items. Suppose if I come out of this, if I don't focus on this window, the animation stops. Okay, as long as the window user is focusing this window, the animation takes place. Okay. So to do that, what we can do is window dot on focus. So we'll write a function, and when window dot on blur, we'll run another function here. Okay. So when the window is focused, what we need to do is first we need to create a handler for the love loader. This is capital L dot each. I am using each function here. The function. So first let's set a const variable here. LoveLoader equal to dollar this. So I can make use of this LoveLoader multiple places. Okay, that is the reason I'm doing this. And for the const, second const will be for the LI item. L item we can get using loveLoader.find, because loveLoader is the UL here, and we'll find the li first child. Okay, we'll get the first child of the li. Next, we'll make use of interval to create a set interval function. So interval is equal to set interval. We'll run a function for every 250 milliseconds. This is set interval close. Okay, so inside the set interval, what we are going to do is, let's create a variable outside the interval. So we will call it let toggler. Initially we'll set the value to 0. So what I'm going to do is, if the toggler value is 0, then we'll append the class even, and when the toggler value is 1, we'll append the class odd. So how to do that? So if toggler is equal to 0, then we need to perform something here, else we need to perform something here. Okay, so what is that is, loveLoader dot, loveLoader is the UL here, so we'll append the li, that is the first child of the UL. We'll append a clone of it with two classes here, add class, one is a clone and another is even. Okay, and we'll set the toggler value to 1 here. Okay, in the else section we are going to do the same thing, but we'll be adding class odd and set the toggler value to 0. Fine. So if we check here, so I found a mistake here, should be loveLoader. So let me refresh this. I found a typo here, so it should be focus. Okay, so when I click on this, as you can see, even odd, so it will be continuing like this. Okay, so let me set this value to a high value for now. Next, what we are going to do is, so we are continuously appending the clone to this loveLoader. Okay, next what we can do here is, we'll target all the clones, CL, so we'll target all the clones and making use of each function again. So we'll run this function for each of the clone, for each clone. So I am setting some const value, setting the clone to $this again, so it becomes handler for the each clone. Okay, so clone dot fade in, so this is a jQuery's method, so we'll fade in, and after fade in we'll run a function. So continuously I'm nesting functions here. So after fade in, what I'm going to do is clone dot animate. So animate takes an object here. So what I'm going to do is, I'll set the font size to high value, say 300 pixel. Okay, so after 1 minute we'll run a function So it is a callback function for the animate. So in this function, what we will be doing is we will fade out the element, and after half second we'll run a callback for this fade out, and we'll remove the element. Okay, this seems to be confusing, but it isn't. Lot of nesting taking place, that's it. So inside the first we are running a fade in. Inside this fade in function we'll running an animate, and inside the animate function we are running a fade out, and the fade out finally we'll remove the element. Okay, so this is what happening. And when the window is in the blur mode, so that is the user is not focusing on this window, then we'll just clear the interval here. Okay, so let's give this a try. When I click on this, so there is an error. Okay, so let's set back this value to 250 and we'll give a try. As you can see, we are continuously adding odd and even classes and creating this cool animation effect. Okay, so when the user is not focusing on this window, automatically the animation gets stopped. Okay, so initially what we can do is we can remove the border on this element and set the opacity to 0. So making this so remove opacity on this element. So we'll apply opacity on the li. Okay, so adding opacity on the li initially hides all the elements. So to make them visible, what we can do is on the even and odd classes we can set the opacity to 1. So this is the cool effect. So hope you enjoyed this video. Please do watch other videos on my channel. Please share and subscribe. I'll make this code available on friendandfun.com, and I'll provide the link in the description below. We'll meet again with an exciting tutorial. Take care.